Hey guys, this is Tony Hunter Tony here with episode 150 of this week's Top 10 Hot Comic Books Found Out in the Wild and or from my beautiful collection. This week's episode is going to feature some really key appearances and some really off-the-wall issues that you did not know about first appearance stuff. I want to share it with you. I've got these at two really cool individual separate entity comic book stores here in Greensboro. They're competition, you know, who's the best. Well, I like them both. They're both friends of mine, and I go in there and I go, hi, I want some comics, here's my money, and they go, get the hell out of here, we don't even know who you are. And then I went to Fairfax, Virginia, and I came into a place called the Amazing Comic Shop. Had a huge collection that they were sifting through. And Thomas, hey buddy, he actually let me peruse through some of the old books, and I found a really cool one I can't wait to share with you. All right, let's get into it. Number 10 of this week's Top 10 Hot Comic Books is, this is Marvel 2-in-1, issue number 41. And what's important with this is The Thing and Brother Voodoo, and they are, there's another guy, it should be called Marvel 3-in-1, the Black Panther is in here. And Brother Voodoo, Black Panther, and the ever-loving blue-eyed Thing, Benjamin Grimm. This is a fantastic book. Look at that all yellow Thing. Should be two-toned. Always confused me. Never seen a different version of this one. It's always yellow, like a printing error or something. Let me know in the comments if you've seen a different version of this. It goes anywhere from $8 to $12, and this is a great get for 10. That is number 10 for 10. Look at that. That is nice. Number 9 of this week's Top 10 Hot Comic Books is, oh, this one's awesome. This is Marvel Spotlight, issue number 4, featuring Captain Marvel. This is a great Steve Ditko story. His art is in here. I love Steve Ditko. And this book, if you hadn't noticed, look down here in the corner. This is early direct edition. It is a low print run. Let me just sit that down. Shining you. This book right here is mid 1979. In 78, they were trying to distribute direct editions more in the country. In New York in the mid 70s, they had maybe 4 stores that they were sending to directly. But then they wanted to broaden their horizons, send it to different shops across the US. The problem was is they had a UPC symbol, and then they were taking those at a discount and then also turning them in for newsstand. You get a higher discount rate for direct edition, but you had to keep it, right? And you got a smaller profit margin on the newsstands, but you could turn it in on the items you didn't sell. That was the two different formulas. In the late 70s and early 80s, as the distribution market expanded, they had to change the product. Look at this. This is number 8 of this week. This also has that UPC with the slash through it, and it had that diamond box up here. A lot of people say that's the price diamond box. That one had a big one. This one had a small one. And you can also find multicolored ones, too, that are out in the world. This book right here, Micronauts, I love this. This was big there in the 70s. Had a toy line out. This goes between $20 and $30. This is a solid get at 25. That is number 8. And what you guys don't know is that those early direct editions and such a low print count are 2 to 4 times more valuable than their newsstand counterparts. By the mid 80s, they were being produced equally. By the end of the 90s and the early 2000s, but mostly right there in the mid 90s, that's when direct edition was getting really taking over, and newsstands was getting really small. So that's why if you're from 93 to 2003, newsstands are scarce and command a higher price. Flip it around, go back in time, 78, 79, 80, right? 80, 81, 81, they start going up. I think it's like 7% of the print count. So any of those late 70 books or early 80s books that are direct edition are a lower count and they have a higher value. There, I said it. It's off my chest. Join the dark side. It took me a long time to believe in the newsstand, which is the main acceptance now, is that that the value is there because the print count is different. It's got to be the reverse. It's got to be the early direct edition. All right, I just got off my soapbox. Number 7 of this week. Look at that. This is another version of that. Look at that. I told you, multicolor box at the top, no UPC. This is an early direct edition. This is also issue number, what is that? That was 13. This is issue number 3 of the Micronauts. I'm blinding you. My apologies. This book is really, this one's awesome. This one's between 20 and 30 bucks, and it's a solid get at 25. That was number 7. I don't know. I always like sharing information with you guys. Number 6 of this week's top 10 hot comic books is, oh, but you don't know what this is. This is issue number 54. This is the new Avengers. This is the 1 in 15 variant cover by Chris Bachalo. It's the first brother Voodoo as a Sorcerer Supreme. This is a huge book. It goes between $25 and $35, and that is a solid get at $30. You know, I wasn't even really big on 1 in 10 or 1 in 15 or 1 in 20 variants back in the day. I didn't really start paying attention to them until the last 3 or 4 years. So it's really crazy that they had them, just didn't know about it. Tony's Target. You know what Tony's Target is? I have no idea, Tony. Why don't you tell me? It's something I have my sights set on, and I got it. And I want to share it with you. Look at this. This is Micronauts number 2. This is a huge looking book. This, because it's really close and shiny, this is one of those books I was talking about. It had the normal large box diamond, had no UPC. This is right at that sweet spot, right in early 1979. You gotta go get these direct editions. It goes between $25 and $35, and that is a solid get at $30. So Tony's Target, I wanted to share with you all that data on, they called them Whitman books, right? Whitman was Western distributors, and Whitman had their own line where they packaged books in plastic. They got that idea because they used to send these out 3 to a bag. So when they sent them out, a lot of those books were late getting to the stores, so they sat on the shelves. They never opened them out of the bag, so you would have one in the front that would be damaged by the poly bag, the one in the back would be damaged by the poly bag, and you'd have one really clean one on the inside. A lot of people thought they were second prints, and they weren't second prints. They were actually first prints that just got delayed getting to the stores. There's some more information for you. Number 5 of this week's top 10 hot comic books is... Look at that. This is Hulk issue number 234. What is really cool about this book is this is the last appearance of Marvel Man and the first appearance of Quasar. He is the protector of the universe, and he changed the name and took up the new moniker of Quasar in this book. I got this at the amazing comic shop in Fairfax, Virginia. Thomas let me look through the our new collection that he got in. They hadn't processed them yet, and he let me look at some books, and I had to get that one. So I just wanted to say thank you. The other, I'm at my midway spot. I'm out of breath. Breathe and relax. These books are being featured from a couple of my local comic shops. I want to give a shout out for Acme Comics, who's located just north of downtown Greensboro. They have a very large selection of back issues, one of the largest Transformer selections in the state. Definitely recommend checking them out. I want to say thank you. They always give me good deals, and they always look out for me. I want to say thank you. The other store is across town. They have a shop here in Greensboro, in Winston-Salem, and in Concord. They're known as Sailfish Comics. They have got a really cool collection everything in there. They got Pops, they got graded slab books, they got a huge wall selection of money books. They're great guys to work with, and with 3 stores, they got 3 times the selection. Just got to be able to travel, which, you know, it's hard to do when you're old and you have a walker. Guys, I want to say thanks for supplying these books to me. I come in, I spend my money, and they throw the books at me and say, "Get the hell out of here!" You know, I don't know why. Number 4 of this week's top 10 hot comic books is, this is Captain America 354. And what you don't know about this, yes you do, this is called the U.S. Agent. This is John Walker. They had that huge announcement about Thunderbolts, and John Walker is going to be part of that team. So when he takes on the moniker of the U.S. Agent, this book is going up. I've seen this as high as $75, but I think a solid get at 40, between 35 and 45 is a good price range. Definitely recommend picking this up, or any early appearance of any of the new Thunderbolts characters. Number 4. Wow, look at that. We're getting through this really fast. Number four is three. Sorry, three, four, three, two, one. This is Defenders number 18. This is really important. Why? Because this is the first appearance of the Wrecking Crew. Yeah, I know. There's a guy called the Wrecker. He appeared in the Thor book, an earlier appearance, but all these other characters to form the Wrecking Crew, this is the first team appearance and origin of this team. They just appeared in a She-Hulk episode. It really didn't do them justice, but they are in the Marvel Universe. And that's their first appearance. Gotta love it. Number two of this week's top 10 hot comic books is... Oh, look at this. This is Tomb of Dracula issue number 18. What's important about this, Tony? Well, I'm glad you asked. This is the first time that the Werewolf by Night and Dracula actually fight. Who doesn't love a Bela Lugosi and the other guy and the black and white movies when the Dracula and the Werewolf fight? Is it the same actor? It can't be the same actor. Hey, leave me down in the comments, the original guys. I can't remember. I wasn't old enough. I was little. I don't remember. My brain hurts. This book right here goes anywhere from 50 to 70 bucks, and it is a solid get at 60. And why is that important? That's another question. Oh, let me answer. Werewolf by Night is going to be appearing in a Halloween special on Disney Plus here at the end of mid-October. All these big clashes between werewolf. You know, Moon Knight appeared in Werewolf. That book is through the roof. Now everyone's going back. Blade appeared in Tomb of Dracula. These books are huge. They're introducing really cool characters, and it was really sweet to have them fighting. It's enough information. Head's going to go. Number one of this week's top 10 hot comic books is... Oh, this one hurts me. All right, so, hey, Tony. Yes, this is Spider-Man 2099. What's wrong with this? Is it a printing error? No, sir. This is a second print that can only be found in a Toy Biz Marvel Legends Spider-Man 2099 figure. They snuck comic books in the back. You know, I love me some Young Avengers because there's a Young Avengers variant comic book in the back of that box toys. Well, some of these toys are really sought after because of the comic books. This one goes as high as $500 in mint condition. It is so hard to find this book in really clean condition because it was in a package meant for toys, and you almost destroyed the comic book getting it out of this clamshell. It's crazy. Look it up. I'm not lying to you. It's really hard to get them out. And even graded, these books are almost $1,000. But to get a really good copy in this condition goes anywhere from $100 to $200, and it is a solid get at $150. That's number one. The bonus of this week. My goodness. Hey, Tony, I thought you said these were supposed to be shorter. Shut up. I'm doing the best I can. The bonus is none other than the San Diego Comic-Con issue number two. What's important about this? Oh, you gotta stop asking me questions and just let me give you the information. This is the first appearance of Hellboy. He appeared in an ash can, and there's only 2,000 of them available. Well, an ash can isn't the same size as a comic book. This is the first comic book appearance of Hellboy. It's even, and there's documentation. This is huge. It goes anywhere from $350 to $450. That's kind of expensive. You know why? Stop asking me questions. It is signed none other than Art Adams. His story in here was called The Shocking Case of the Brief Journey. And it's also signed by Jeff Darrow. And his story in here is like a two-page story. It's called The Big Guy and Rusty the Robot. With those two signatures on this book, that's what commands this high price. This is a beautiful book, and that is a great bonus. Guys, this week's hunt totals over $860. That's not bad. Did you guys know that any of these books can be got? All you got to do is go to the individual book and type claim in the bottom. I'll send you exact information for shipping and pricing for insurance and the book. If you want any of those, they're available. But if you want all 12 of them, you can get them and be the big game hunter and save over 15% off. And then also you'll get free shipping in the continental U.S. And then if you're outside the continental U.S. and you want all those bad boys, I'll take $15 off the actual shipping cost. Whoo! Guys, I want to say thank you for watching episode 150 Redo. It is a great great batch of books. I want to thank the stores I mentioned earlier for taking care of me. Guys, I want to say thank you, and I'll see you on the next hunt. Bye-bye.